This video is brought to you by Longoni Qs.
Do you wish you could push out and take the initiative like this? Or outsmart your opponent and win the game like this? Hi pool players, this is Terminator. Welcome back to another episode of Terminator Tips. In this new series, we're going to cover everything about the pushout. Which pushouts are available to us and why we would shoot them. So let's get started right now. Here we are, pool players, at my beautiful Pro Start table. I've received a lot of requests about the topic of the pushout. Personally, I find it one of the most fascinating moments in a rotation game because we really get to play our opponent head on. We have to think about our opponent's weapons and weaknesses, then also our own, and make a tactical decision of what we're gonna do based upon that. The statistics say right out of the gate that when you're pushing out, you're an underdog 3-1. That's because your opponent will step to the table. He has the option now and all the choice to take the shot on or give it back to you. So he has the advantage right there. What you want to do is always think, how can I win from here? But you have to make it as tough as possible within your own limits. So when your opponent steps to the table, they have to be faced with a tough shot. When they give it back to you, it's also going to be tough for you. But it has to be doable. You have to be able to execute a good shot, and with practice and over time, you can take more and more risk and make the shot harder and harder because you will start improving. I've done some analyzing and I've come up with 6 ways of how we can push out. 3 of them are offense and 3 of them are defense. In this episode here, I'm going to give you an example of each of those push-out options. And then in the upcoming videos, we're going to dive in much deeper with more and more examples of offensive and defensive ways we can push out. So example number 1, we're going to push out for an open shot. Keep in mind, you don't want to give up an open shot where your opponent can play natural position and just run out the game. This would be too easy. Try to give your opponent, for example, a straight-in shot, frozen on the rail, with limited options. So it's going to be a shooting challenge, but in such a way that your opponent or you cannot run out right away. Your mission is you want to try and extend the game. Here, for example, the one ball's here after the break. I'm hooked behind the 2. I can potentially call push out and play as close to the corner as possible, give my opponent a straight in shot on the 1. If he takes it on, he's going to have no open shot on the 2 to run out. So my mission has been accomplished with extending the game. Your opponent has to play defense after he chooses to make this ball. So you will get back to the table and have your say in this rack. The second way we can potentially push out is pushing out for a kick shot. Efren Reyes introduced this into the rotation games and he was the grandmaster at this. He had me fooled many, many times after the push out. I learned a lot of lessons and I also saw him do it on many other opponents. For example here, we're hooked after the break on the 1. The 9 is here, the 6 is here. I can't push out to any of these spots. Over here, you can still cut it in. This would be too tough. But if I can just tap the 9 ball, I'm still hooked on the 1. But now I have a potential 2 rail kick. Kick behind the 1. Send the 1 over here. Leave the cue ball there. And maybe have a resave behind this 6-9. Let's see if we can pull one off. First try, actually, with some practice, you can get a better feel for this. I'm gonna put a link here in the top with some of these kick shots that come up all the time. Nice little shot here to extend the rack. Let's move on to example number 3. Pushing out for jump shots has always been one of my favorite over the years. If you're a pretty good jumper, I see no harm in challenging your opponent to see who can make that ball and who can't, and take it from there. For example here, I'm hooked behind the 6-9. It's very hard to push out for a defensive shot. Anywhere I push out here, it's gonna be very easy to get behind these balls. Anywhere I push out here, I'm gonna leave an open shot. So what do you do? How can you win the game from here? Well, I'm gonna push out for a jump shot, challenge my opponent. It's a bit too close now, so I have to push it down a little bit more and challenge my opponent to see who can make the one, and then a potential bank shot on the two or save, take the game from there. Let's see if I can pull one off. There you go, needed a couple of tries also. I still find that if there's no good tactical safety available after the push out, this is a great option to take control of the rack if you're a pretty good jumper. And then the higher the level is, you cannot be fooling around with your opponent. They're gonna punish you with making all sorts of shots or safeties. You have to take control of the rack as fast as you can. So this is a good offensive push out opportunity. Here's the fourth example of how we can push out. This time it's gonna be for a safety shot. There's no offensive opportunities really when I'm hooked behind this two ball. The pocket is blocked by the three. I can't do anything with a jump, no kick shots, so I have to push out for a safety. Again, try to make it hard on your opponent where there's a chance that he can give it back to you. If they do give it back to you, you have to be able to execute these shots. If you're failing on this, I have some great training to practice your safety game and get much better at it fast. So for example here, in this situation, I could push out to the middle diamond, try to freeze my opponent, and then from here, if I cut it on the left side, send the one to the middle diamond, one rail, I could use this 7 or 5 to hook my opponent back and really put him in trouble. If he or she will see the same shot as you do, then it's gonna be a battle for who can play safeties the best. First try, that's not too bad. I'll take that any day. Here in example 5, we have a very interesting situation. The one ball's down there, I'm hooked behind the 6. If I push out anywhere to this side of the table, there's not much I can do with a safety shot because the 3 is preventing me from going to this side of the table and getting behind these balls again. Very hard to do. There's no potential blockers here, here. What can we do? There's no real offensive shot, but if you're pretty confident in your banking skills, then you can challenge your opponent to a long bank. That's the only real shot here that can win you the game. If you push out to this position here, it's a question of who can knock in this long bank and take control of this rack. Second try. So if you're a pretty good banker, this is one you want to keep in mind. And it doesn't always feel good because if you would miss it, you give up an open rack. But sometimes that's what you have to do. You got to take that chance to try and win the game. And here in the final example, a much overlooked option is to tie up some balls and extend the rack. If the rack is wide open like we see here and I would push out for an open shot, I'm giving my opponent a chance to run out and I don't want to do that. I want to try and extend the game. I can't really push out for a jump either. It's going to be too close also with the 5. There's no kick shot available, but the 3 and 8 are laying beautifully. All I have to do is realize this, tie these balls up as such. Don't forget to call the push out. Push out, tied him up, and I've just extended the game because my opponent is virtually unable to run out now in one inning. Be careful with your decision making on these shots. You have to realize that if, for example, the two ball would have been here, then our opponent could knock in the one, play position, and open these balls up right away. Then it wouldn't be too smart. We have to look for another solution. But as we see here, when the two is there, it's very hard for opponent now play position or even open up these balls. So in this example, this is smart thinking. We've tied up some balls. Our opponent is not able to run out in one inning. We've extended the game, and we will get back to the table, hopefully, to create something where we can win that rack. There you have it, pool players. Some powerful knowledge about the pushout. Join me in the next episode where we're going to go over more offensive examples. Don't forget to check out all the other great content on the channel. There's tips and lessons here uploaded weekly. And remember to head over to TerminatorCollege.com if you're interested in the mental side of the game, and check out all those courses that are waiting there for you. Take care.